Okay, so what we're going to do is create a top. It's going to look something like this. Then we can print it out in plastic. So the first thing you want to do is to get into SolidWorks. So get into SolidWorks, new document, new part, so that new page and then part, okay. Then you're going to want to create a sketch. We're just going to create a square to input the image of the top. We want to be on the front plane. So go into your square, and then we're going to smart dimension our square, and we'll make it an inch and a half by inch and a half. Just make it square for now. Features, extrude, extrude it out. A tenth of an inch is fine. Then again, we want to be in the front. So then we're going to search up. So I searched up the Forever Spin Top. And then I took the first image here. So you're going to right click on it, save link as. Forever Spin, or whatever you want it to be. Save image as, I'm sorry, not save link as, save image as, and you want it to be a JPEG. So Forever Spin JPEG works. Save it. And then you're going to go back into your SolidWorks, import the image. So click on the front face, okay? Click on the front face, and then appearances will come up. Click that, and then click on your face, the face option. Don't click on your face. Go into advanced. You're going to browse for that Forever Spin top and put that on the desktop. So if you don't notice the Forever Spin in your list, it's because you don't have the correct file format. So go into all images and then Forever Spin. Open that up and then you have it here. It's going to prompt you to save it again. Save it. And then you're going to zoom in with your top. If you want to center it, you can center it. But zooming in, you just click on the corner, click and drag it out. That's all you're doing. Clicking and dragging it out. But if you want it in the center, you're going to have to go to mapping and then surface. And then you're going to have to move it around. So move it down a little bit, move it to the left a little bit, and then you get it centered. So that's under mapping. And then once you have the top where you want it, check it off. So we're just using this image to trace. And then we're going to actually take that sketch and make it 3D. So we're just going to trace over this image using a sketch. So go into sketch, click the front of your face of your object. First thing I want to do is create a center line. So go into the line command, the drop down, center line, zoom in, get to about the center, looks good from there, and I'm going to drop it all the way down to the center over here. If it's not exactly in the center, it's okay, but I want that horizontal snap, that yellow horizontal snap to be on. So that's what I need to be careful with. So it snapped, it's at 90 degrees, and we're good. So to get out of this line command, hit escape, which is the top left button, ESC. Then I'm going to go into spline. I'm just going to trace over the outside of this top. I'm only going to do half of it because I'm going to revolve it. So snap to the top. I'm going to zoom in a little more. More points the better, because these points are inflection points. Notice both sides of the point move, right? Inflection. It's a calculus term too. I believe it's the second derivative, where your acceleration goes from negative to positive, depending on the object's falling or going up. All right, you're gonna keep going down. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Keep going down, down, and then once I get to a spot, I'm going to hit escape to get out of my spline function. I'm going to make this a straight line. I don't have to make this a straight line. I could have kept going with my spline, but it's just the choice I'm going to make. Get out of that, and then go back to my spline to make the curves. And I'm going to start here. I'm going to bend it. Keep bending it. Keep bending it around. And then escape again to get out of spline. So now I have the sketch. So exit sketch. And I'm gonna, when I exit the sketch, right, I'm gonna select it again. I'm gonna select my sketch, and I'm gonna open the window, and I'm gonna copy this image by hitting Control C. So now it's copied on a clipboard that we can't see. The computer copied the image. I'm going to exit sketch again. Now I'm going to open up, just for time purposes, I'm just going to open up a new file part. Make sure again I'm in inches. I am, so I'm good. Control V, and notice the sketch just popped up, which is good. Then I'm going to go into the sketch. So I'm going to go into that view by hitting orientation and then front. And now I'm going to revolve this sketch. So to manipulate the sketch, I'm going to edit the sketch, features, revolve. Sketch is currently open. A non-thin revolution feature requires a closed sketch. Would you like to sketch to be automatically closed? Yes. Because the center line doesn't automatically close your object, but it prompts you to do that anyway. So with that, it automatically selects your line, and it goes 360 degrees revolution. Check it off, and I'm good. So that's the top. That can get printed out. You can add features to it if you wanted to fillet it, or if you wanted to chamfer it, you can do that. So I'll add a fillet, if I can find it. There we go. Fillet, and then I'll just select the top edge. I can reduce that if I wanted to, but looks good enough to me. So it gives a little edge to it. That'll be rounded. Okay, so then I am going to save this. If I wanted to print it, I'm going to save it as an STL file, assuming that I would be printing it from the plastic printer, one of the plastic printers, not the powder printer. STL, and then ask me where to save it or where you normally do save things to get printed, and then just save it, and we'll print it.